In this video, I'll be showing you where the formula estimate at completion equals to our budget at completion divided by CPI comes from, which is used during forecasting in earned value management. I'll be simplifying the formula where the CPI is the same for the remaining project work in order to forecast the estimate at completion. Now, the formula that is most often provided in learning material is our estimate at completion equals to the budget at completion divided by CPI. CPI is our cost performance index, but the question that is always asked is where does this formula comes from? I will also add the links in the description box to some of my other videos that explains the basic earned value management formulas. So in forecasting, our estimate at completion is the expected total cost of all the completed work on our project. And it's calculated by adding our actual cost plus our estimate to complete, which is equal to our estimate at completion. Now, our estimate to complete is the remaining project work, and that is calculated by subtracting our budget at completion minus our earned value. That's a percentage complete at a specific point in time. So it's our actual cost at a specific point in time plus our estimate to complete, so the remaining work to complete the project, and the remaining work to complete the project is our budget at completion minus our earned value. Now, if the CPI is the same for the remaining project work, in order to forecast our estimate at completion, it is calculated by adding our actual cost, so it's our actual cost, plus our budget at completion minus earned value, divided by the CPI. And when we simplify the formula, we get estimate at completion equals to our budget at completion divided by CPI. So let's do the simplification. So it's our actual cost plus budget at completion minus earned value divided by CPI. Now, the CPI is our earned value divided by actual cost. So let's replace the CPI with earned value divided by actual cost. So that's our actual cost plus budget at completion minus earned value divided by earned value divided by actual cost. Now, if we multiply above line and below the line with our actual cost, the actual cost cancels out below the line. So then we've got our actual cost plus actual cost times budget at completion minus earned value divided by earned value. The actual cost cancels out. Now, our actual cost plus actual cost times budget at completion divided by earned value minus actual cost times earned value, actual cost times earned value divided by earned value. And our earned value cancels out. So then we've got our actual cost plus actual cost times budget at completion divided by earned value minus actual cost. Our earned value cancels out. Now, plus actual cost minus actual cost cancels out. Then we've got our actual cost times budget at completion divided by earned value. So if we multiply above and below the line with 1 over actual cost, the actual cost cancels out at the top of the line. So we got our budget at completion divided by earned value on actual cost. Now, your earned value divided by actual cost is our cost performance index. So we replaced earned value divided by actual cost with CPI. So we've got our budget at completion divided by the CPI. So it's our budget at completion divided by CPI. So if the CPI is the same for the remaining project work, then the estimate at completion can be calculated by actual cost plus budget at completion minus earned value divided by CPI, which is the same as the budget at completion divided by CPI. I hope this video helped you to better understand where the formula estimate at completion equals to your budget at completion divided by CPI comes from. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you are interested in future videos, you're welcome to subscribe.